friends. Thanks for joining us today. My name is Kim Murdoch and you're watching Arts Hub Online. So today I'm going to teach you how to make this really fun craft. This craft is simple and easy and it's made out of cereal boxes. So it doesn't have to be a cereal box. If you have something different like a seltzer box or any type of food packaging box will work. It just needs to be a kind of a medium thickness cardboard. You don't need a lot of supplies for this today. You do need a pair of scissors and a pencil at the very least. It wouldn't be bad if you had a Sharpie, but if you don't have a Sharpie, that's okay. And you need some markers. And that's all you need, guys. In just a minute, we're gonna get started. See you in a minute. So you do need, like I said, some type of box. And what I'd like you to do is go ahead and open them up. So just do that very carefully so you don't get a paper cut. And flatten them out. So these are really great. You can get these in the recycling bin. You can save them for future projects. That's what I do. So I'm just going to have a little stack right here, but we're going to start with the one that's on top. And what we're going to do is we're going to take our scissors and we are going to cut on one of these seams. You can see how there's these folds in the boxes and that's the place where you want to cut. So I'm just going to take my scissors and I'm not too worried about cutting a straight line, but I'm just going to go ahead and cut up this fold and then my box will open up like that. So you got your big box and I'm just going to go ahead and cut on these other lines just to make it so it's easier for me to use. So you can see there's one and this one's going to be skinny. This is from the side of the box. And sometimes you might think that you won't need that for anything, but you can always use it for something. It's useful. So just set it aside for another time. So I'm going to go ahead and cut here again and set that aside again. So now we've got some nice pieces of sort of medium cardboard that's not too thick, not too thin. I'm going to set that aside and I'm going to get this right in front of me. And so let's look at these fish. So first of all, let's look at what they are. So this fish is just a general fish shape that I drew and I made this one as well, and I wanted it to look a little bit different. So one is bigger, one is smaller. You can see they're made out of two different kinds of cereal boxes. These little stands, I'm going to teach you how to make these later. These are really important. They help your fish and your objects stand up, but we don't need them right now. So I just wanted to show you, these are the seaweed that I made. And so what I'd like you to think about is we're going to be drawing some of those objects on this board together, okay? But what I'd like you to see is that this fish takes up just like a section of this, and this one also, right? So if you were to imagine, you can see that, let's see if you can see that if I hold that up, you could get all of these pieces off the same piece of cardboard. What I don't want you to do is draw something right in the center and then cut that out, because then you're kind of wasting it. So first things first, what I'd like you to do is take your Sharpie. If you're using a pencil or a marker, that's fine. It doesn't have to be right in the middle exactly, but just do the best you can. Go ahead and draw a line right down the middle. Then we're going to turn it and we're going to do the same thing again. And so I'm not trying to make this exactly perfect. I just want it to be, you see this one's a little bigger than that one. That's no big deal. But what I want to do is just give myself some sections. So now that I have those sections, I'm going to put different things in each one. Now I have these fish and I have the seaweed, and that's what I'm going to do today. But once you get going with this, remember you got a whole stack of cereal boxes over here. You can make all kinds of things. You could make an octopus. You could make a mermaid. You could make a treasure chest, whatever you like, a shark. But first, we're going to do this together so you get the idea of how it works. So what I would like you to do is just pick one of these four sections. And the very first thing we're going to do is draw the front of our fish's face. And I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to ask you to do the same thing. So there you go. See how I drew that? Looks a lot like an M. But that is our fish's mouth. And so what I'm going to do now is draw a curving line and a curving line like that. And so do you see how I just connected it and it's like an oval? So our fish needs some fins. So I'm going to draw one on the top And I'm going to draw one on the bottom, and I'm only going to put it where it makes sense. So it doesn't matter if it's big or small, you can have them wherever you want to. I also want to make sure my fish has a tail. So I'm going to go ahead and draw a nice big fish tail. And do you see how I have used up as much of this space as I can? Just like we don't want to draw a fish in the middle of this, we don't want to draw a tiny fish in the middle of this smaller section either. We want to use our space, we want to fill it up. So I'm not going to worry about the details right now. I'm going to go on to my second fish, and I think this guy is really cute. He is a little bit smaller. You could even probably get two of those in there if you want to, or you could just draw it bigger. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to draw this one's face, and this one has the same start, but you can see how it's not so close to the edge. It's a little farther over. And that's because I want to make sure I have enough room to draw this shape right here. Okay. And two little shapes there. So you can already see that this fish is really a different shape than the other one. And your fish can have whatever shape you want. It could have big fins or little fins, just like I said. I'm going to draw up now and back. And so this is the body. And this tail, let's look at how different this tail is. You see how that one's kind of long and skinny? So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna do the best we can to show that shape. So I have now drawn a tail. It looks like a crescent moon to me. All right, so these fish are done. I'm not gonna draw anything else on them right now. We'll come back to the details later. What I'd like you to think about now is your seaweed. So the seaweed's fun to draw. It's a lot of wiggly lines, it's squiggly, wiggly. You can decide how big you want it to be or if you want it to be really wide or really narrow. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do some wiggly lines like this and come back down. See how I did that? So I started right on the line, went all the way up, all the way back down. I'm gonna do that again, and I'm gonna just make it a different shape, a little bit of a different shape. It doesn't have to be the same. It can be a little different, like I said. All right, guys, so once you've drawn your shapes, what I'd like you to do, if you have a Sharpie, is go ahead and close that up. And we are now going to cut this on these lines we drew, and that's gonna make it easier when it's time to cut out our fish and our seaweed. So I'm cutting right on that line. And remember when I talked about cutting off these little extra things, we don't need that. So we're going to cut that off. And we're going to save that, of course, for another day. And I'm going to cut now down here. And then I'm going to just do the same thing on this piece. So just take your time. I want you to cut all these four pieces out. And when we come back and you have your four pieces like this, I'll tell you what the next step is. Okay, so the next step is to turn this cardboard fish into this colorful fish. And as you can see, this one I chose, I used markers with purples and yellows and oranges. You can do any color you want, but we do need to do some basic details on the fish. We're gonna draw its face with its eye, also its gills and the lines on its fins and maybe a few scales. So what I'd like you to do is we're going to draw on this before we cut it out. So I'm going to draw here and then I'm going to hold it up for you to see. First thing I'd like you to do is draw a curving line like that. So I did do that with my Sharpie. Again, you can do it with your pencil or your marker if you need to. Then I'm going to draw another one right here, and that's going to help make it clear where my fish's mouth is. So do you see this purple mouth here? This is the same shape. So a fish usually has a big round eye, so I'm gonna go ahead and create that nice big round eye for my fish. And you can do any type of details you want. If you want to have polka dots or stripes, those are things you can do in just a couple minutes. So this is a fin, and this is a fin, and this is the tail, but we need to have a fin right here in the middle of the body. So I'm gonna go ahead and draw that. See how I drew that right in the middle? And what I'd like you to do is go ahead and draw some lines on that one. Just like that. So the next thing we're gonna do is do the same types of lines on the other fins. And just take your time. You get going, you feel like you wanna add another fin, then go ahead. See how I added another little fin right there? That is up to you. So in order for our fish to breathe, they need gills. And so we're gonna go ahead and draw a few gills. Those are just some stripes. They're kind of like curving lines right near the back of the head. The tail of our fish also has lines on it. And so I'm gonna go ahead and draw them, and then I'm gonna hold that up for you. See how they curve a little bit? So now to finish our fish, we're just gonna draw a few scales. Now you can draw all the scales if you want to. However, sometimes as an artist, you only have to draw a couple of scales to show that the scales are there. It's like drawing hair or something else, or feathers. You don't have to draw every single one. If you just draw a couple, then that shows the detail. I'm gonna go do a little curving line on each scale just to give it a little bit of decoration. And like I said, if you want this fish to have polka dots or stripes or zigzags or any type of design, you are welcome to do that. I'm gonna set this aside for a few minutes, and then I'm gonna work on my second fish. So if you will remember, we drew our second fish, and this one is kind of based off an angelfish. And so what I'd like you to do first is we're going to draw the fish's eye. And these fish, they have a big round eye as well, but it's really, really big. So what I'd like you to do is draw the eye first. They have a stripe on their body. They have a lot of stripes, but the main thing is the first stripe goes right past their eye. And that happens in real life. It's really quite amazing. So we're gonna draw a stripe that goes right past this fish's eye. Then what I'd like you to do is go ahead and draw a few more stripes. And I want you to notice how I'm keeping my stripes curving. Looks almost like a crescent moon again. And that helps show us that this fish's body is round. So I've drawn one from underneath, two from up here. And I wanna go ahead and draw some lines now on my fins. And these are a little different than the other fish because instead of going up and down, these lines go across. So I'd like you to just take a moment and draw some lines that go across, which makes your fish very cool looking. Same thing on this tail. So just take a moment, draw those lines, bring them all the way across. And pretty soon he's looking, I like this guy, he looks pretty cool. If you feel like you are needing another stripe, it is your fish. You can add some more. See how I added a couple more down there? All right, friends, so that fish is done. We're gonna do some seaweed. Now, the good news is your seaweed is already done. You don't have to do anything to it. If you wanna add a detail to it, you can add a couple lines like this. That just makes it look a little more wavy. Those are details. If you like the way that looks, go right ahead. I think I'll do that today. So I just drew some wavy lines on my seaweed. All right. So now it's time to do the coloring. So I'm going to let you do this on your own. When I come back, I'm going to show you what I did. Then we're going to cut them out. And then all we have to do to finish is talk about making these little stands. So have fun coloring. And when we come back in just a couple minutes, I'll show you what I did. Okay. So we have been hard at work over here. I colored in this one and Mr. Dan did this one. He did a great job. And we got some seaweed. I wanted to show you how this seaweed's a little different. They both have light green and dark green on there, but you can see they just look different. They don't have to be exactly the same. So guys, now we just need to cut these out. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. And when we come back, I'll show you what the next step is. All right, so you have cut up your fish, right? And your seaweed. What I like to do is make the bottom of the seaweed a little bit rounded. It just looks a little more natural when it's standing up. So now guys, it's time to make these little stands. And so this is just a rectangle of cardboard. And so I'm going to use one of these long strips. So what I think you should do first is try to make them approximately the same size. So I'm going to go ahead and cut one. I'm going to put it right here. And I'm going to cut there. And I'm going to do it again. And I won't be able to get a fourth one out of this to make it the same size, so I'm just going to recycle those. Let me go back to my other one. And I'm basically just going to do this again. Because they don't have to be exactly the same, but they should be about the same. So, save this other one for a rainy day. Now, you'll notice that this has like a little edge to it. You just want to trim those up and make them kind of neat. So, I'm going to take a second here and just do the best I can to try to make them a little neater, more like a neater rectangle. So, do that for just a minute. And looks pretty good. So these stands are not hard to make, but sometimes they're a little bit tricky. So let's see what we can do. So you should have four of them now that are about the same size. I'm gonna take one, I'm gonna fold it like this. See, it's like a little book. I'm gonna do the very best I can to make it even. And by even, I mean, when you stand it up, it's like a little tent. See what I mean? So you want that to be pretty even. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to take my Sharpie, but you can use the edge of your scissors if that's easier. And I'm gonna press on that. I wanna make a really good crease. And I'm just gonna set that there, move on to my next one. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna fold it, try my best to make them level. Use something else, whether it's a Sharpie or the edge of your scissors. This is how you use the edge of your scissors. Get nice and level. Now these don't have to be the same height, meaning this one's a little taller than that one, and that's not a big deal. But we just need them to be sturdy to hold up our fish and our seaweed. So I'm going to do a third one. And I'm going to set it right there. Now this last one has a little extra piece of cardboard on here from where how the box was put together, and you can just pull that right off. And it's easier to fold when that's not there. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing. I'm gonna do my best to make it even. And if it's not even, you can either A, make more, or B, give it the old haircut. A haircut meaning just to trim it a little. Okay, so we've got our four little stands, and now we have to put this little, I guess it's like a slit. I don't know how you can see that from there, but it's really just done with your scissors. So what I want you to do is you're gonna keep this folded. You may need an adult's help for this because you're gonna be cutting through two pieces of cardboard. But do the very best you can to do this right in the middle. And the secret is to not do it too far, because if you do it too far, you're going to cut all the way through it and it will be in two pieces. So when you do that, then you have a place to put your fish. And you have to kind of get it in the right spot where it's going to balance. There you go. So that one looks pretty good. You can also tilt it a little bit. You can have them go in different directions. So I like how that looks. So there's one. Move on to the next one. Again, you might need a parent's help. I'm gonna cut a little notch right there and take your second fish. And you're gonna just slide that in there, just like that. And you can play around with this until you get them sort of in the position you want them to be in. All right, guys. Now, I haven't done it yet, but I really love this project. You can go with any theme you want. It doesn't have to be underwater. It could be the Wild West. You could do like cactus and cowboy and a horse, or maybe you could do something from Harry Potter and make a whole scene of Harry Potter characters. That'd be fun. Or Star Wars. Once you get the hang of it, this is just really, really fun. So, got my fish, got my seaweed. They're having a good time. They're about to have a party with these guys. We'll just go ahead and just do one more just for fun. Just so you get the idea. Anyway, guys, this is really fun. I hope you enjoyed it. I really did. And next week we're gonna do something that I love, love, love. And it is using something that may surprise you. I'm gonna teach you how to make this cool sunflower. Can anyone guess what I painted this with? Any ideas? Well, I'll tell you what it is. It's instant coffee. So, very excited about this. It's fun to do. I'll see you next time.